I would like to present you the project which we make together with people from Poland, from Slovakia, Ukraine, and USA. The project was named Impact of World War West on the formation and also transformation of the scientific life of the mathematical community. So now let me say some words about our motivation, about the motivation of our project. The first stimulus was in Italia. In 2016, in a small town Asiago, there was a special international seminar, Minerva Armata, La Università, La Grande Guerra. And this seminar was devoted to the international conference on the World War First and the scientific academic life in Europe during the war. So there were many interesting lectures, discussions, and also impulses for thinking about future research. It was so that the situation, especially in West and South Europe, is very well analyzed and described, but the situation in the Central Europe was outside the interest of our historians of science. You can see the placard of the conference Minerva Armata. So the second impulse was in Poděbrady, small town near Prague, when in the August 2016, there were the conference on the history of mathematics, international conference, and some participants were also from Poland, Slovakia, and Hungary. There we have a long and deep discussions with Czech and also our foreign colleagues, and we are looking for the potential members of our team. The first work for preparations of our project was made in Poděbrady in August 2016. From the summer of this year until the spring of the next year, we work on the preparation of our project. You can see the map of Czech Republic with the point of town Poděbrady. What we can say about the timing of our project? We think that the timing of our project seems to be optimal for the following reasons. Firstly, almost 100 years have expired from the end of the World War First, which makes it possible to look at the mathematical communities and also mathematics and their history from a broad and historical perspective. For the second reason, we think that several European historians were deeply interested in the topic, and our project, we think, might present a suitable platform for a successful international collaboration and for the exchange of ideas and our opinions. And certainly, many older archival sources and materials were digitalized and are available to scholars and to research. What we know about the situation of Western and South Europe? We know that the role of World Warfest and its influence on scientific life in the interwar period, especially on the mathematical communities, has been studied in Western and Southern Europe and also in the USA. But there exist only some studies that are rather fragmented. They often analyze separately the historical roots of changing by considering special local principles, describing sometimes only the historical aspects with an emphasis on political and social perspective, or study only the scientific point of view with an absent historical contents. So we decided to concentrate on Central Europe because the study of the interwar development of the mathematical communities in Central Europe, their scientific achievements, international collaboration, and so on, has suffered from the disinterest of historians in general, as well as of historians of mathematics and mathematicians, although we think these topics represent a part of European and also world science, culture, and history. This has to do with the significantly limited access to archive sources, the widely held opinion that the majority of sources had not been preserved. So, after a long hour discussions, we decided for many, many things. We wanted to bring an original insight into the history of mathematical communities in Central and Eastern Europe in the interwar period. We also wanted to focus on the transformation of scientific life between the wars. We also wanted to analyze the impact of the new states formation, Russian Revolution, economic crisis, and also emigration on academic institutions, but with the emphasis of mathematics or on mathematics. We also decided to describe the situation at the newly established or reorganized higher education and research institutions in Czechoslovakia, Poland, Hungary, Germany, and Russia. Next, we also wanted to recognize political, economic, social, and also cultural phenomena which strongly influence the development of science and technology, academic and research institutions, universities, and higher system education systems. We wanted to pay attention also to social phenomena, such as the reconstruction and development of international cooperation, the effects of religious persecutions in Central Europe, and also the rise of anti-Semitism. We decided to show how the shape of the academic landscape and the development of science are strongly interwoven with the political situation and also prevailing attitudes in society at the time. Next, we wanted to recognize a phenomena of great importance, which was, for example, the emancipation of women and their attempts to change their fates, their status in the society and their position in the academia or research, but with the emphasis on mathematics, only on mathematics. We decided to write also several specialized case studies describing a typical mathematical career of the mathematicians from Central and Eastern Europe in the interwar period. We wanted also to analyze, summarize, describe, compare, and comment on the achievements of the mathematical communities in Central and Eastern Europe. We also discussed that we wanted to show the role and scientific contribution of mathematical communities in the Central and Eastern Europe to the development of some mathematical disciplines. Then we decided to make the case studies on the set theory, combinatorics, and also on the analysis. We decided to analyze the origin and significance of some mathematical ideas on the developing trends in world mathematics. And also, we wanted to put our research into wider historical aspects because we decided to fill in a substantial gap in the current literature. And at the end, we decided to organize national and international seminars, workshops, and conferences. We have many questions, for example, how, why, when, and under what situation did it all happen? What sources can be used, can be studied? Where sources can be found? How to analyze them, because we have many, many sources. But we also describe how to write and publish our results and what will be interested for national communities and also for the international readers. We decided to use these working methods. The project was based on extensive research archives and libraries. We decided to use mathematical journal monographs, textbooks, and reviews journal published in the interwar period, as well as the modern internet databases of mathematical works, their abstracts and reviews, and also some databases of historical literature. The project benefits from national prosopographical databases of sciences. We also used encyclopedic dictionaries, bibliographical and biographical papers on the life and work of prominent mathematicians. The team benefit from their previous works. The collected materials were analyzed, evaluated, and commented on from national and international perspectives. And the existing opinions and results were compared and confronted. And we tried also redefine and explain them. Our project was for the first time make us interdisciplinary and international project in the nature. Let me present you the team. Research team. I was the boss of the team. Then we have nine colleagues. The colleague from Slovakia. Slovakia was described by Vojtech Balint, and he also wrote about the situation in Hungary because he is Hungarian. Next, we have a very good collaborators for Poland. We collaborated with professors Roman Duda from Wrocław, Stanisław Domoracki from Rzeszów, and then we also work from Margareta Stawiska-Friedland. You know them, she is from USA. The situation in Ukraine was described by Michal Zaryczny. Next member of the team were from Czechoslovakia. The team from Czechoslovakia by composed from my husband, Professor Bečváš, and his colleagues, Ivan Netuka and Antonín Slavík and Jiří Veselý. All of them are from the Charles University in Prague. We decided to show some support, and we was successful. Our international project was supported by the Czech Science Foundation. The support was for the years 2018 to 2020. So after 5 years, it's mean 2 years for the project preparation and 3 years for the realization, we obtain some results. So let me introduce you the main results. The main results are four books. First of them is book written by me and my colleague, Professor Netuka. The book is name Impact of the First of the World War First on the International Collaboration of Mathematicians. You can see the title pages of this book, and I can say that this book was published in the 2019 in the publishing house of the Czech Technical University. What I can say about this book to present you, it's a context. So we can say that the monograph deals with the origins and transformation of the international cooperation of mathematicians in the long period. What does it mean? In the period from the end of the 80s of the 19th century to the beginning of the World War II. The individual chapters illustrate for the first how war conflicts, political decisions, social climate, economic instability, and also personal conflicts positively or negatively influence the life of the scientific community and also affected its professional development. Next, we can say that the text focuses primarily for the first on the five pre-war international congresses of mathematicians. You can see the date of this conference, and also in the five inter-war international congresses of mathematicians, usually from the point of view of the mathematician from the Central Europe. The origin of the first international organization, as we can know, it was International Union of Mathematicians, which was founded in 1990. We show how this organization influenced and influences the development of mathematics and mathematical community. We try describe it. Next, we wrote also about the activities of the very well now International Commission on Mathematics Education, which was created in 1908. And we discuss its role in the reform of teaching mathematics in European countries during the first third of the 20th century. Next, we try to speak about the historical situation on the creation of the first important international mathematical prize, the so-called Fields Medal, which was set up in 1932. And after very complicated international discussion was firstly awarded in 1936 and for the second time after the World War II. Our second book was written by me, and this book is devoted to the history of female doctorates at the both university in Prague from the 1900 until 1945. The book was published by the printing house of Charles University in the 2019 in Prague. You can see the cover page. And what I can say about the book is devoted to the larger in a now and mostly forgotten history of female candidates of PhD degree in mathematics in the period 1882 until 1945 at the German University in Prague and also at the Czech University in Prague, it's mean at the Charles University. And I decided to analyze the following topics. Firstly, I give the background to the women's studies at the universities in the Czech lands. Secondly, I try to describe the rules and regulation in the process of obtaining doctoral degrees. Then I give some statistical overview of all PhD degrees in mathematics awarded at both universities in that time. I give also a short survey of successful and also unsuccessful female doctoral procedures. And I try analyze the social and historical background of their life stories, professional activities, and fates of their families and relatives. Our third book was written by my husband and by me. The name is Jarník's Notes on the Lecture Course Allgemeine Ideal Theory by Warden, Göttingen, 1927-1928. The book was published in English in the series History of Mathematics as its 6-4 volumes, and the book was published in December 2020. So what I can say about this book? In the book, there are for first time reproduced, analyzed, and commented on the unique archival materials. What I mean? I mean Jarník's mathematical notebooks, which he wrote in the academic year 1927-28 in Göttingen, and which contain a record of the lecture delivered by Warden during his famous course entitled Allgemeine Ideal Theory. Jarník's notebooks were discovered by my husband in Zsigmecsvás in 2004, when he preparing an extensive monograph on the life and work of Vojtěch Vladimír Kořínek, who was a Czech algebraist, famous algebraist of the 20th century. So, what about the content of this book? Firstly, the life, mathematical achievements, and pedagogical work of Vojtěch Jarník and Van der Waarden are described. Then, the life of mathematical community in Göttingen is analyzed, but the main part of the book is the commented reproducing of the Van der Waarden's lecture Allgemeine Ideal Theory. The book mainly concentrates on, firstly, comparison of the content, structure, mathematical concept, and style of mathematical interpretation of Van der Waarden's lectures with his famous textbooks, Modern Algebra I and Modern Algebra II, which I think strongly influenced generation of mathematicians, not only between World War I and World War II. Then we concentrate on a description of how Warden's lecture lectures reflected the state of the art and thinking in modern algebra following 1928. And we also analyzed the role of distinguished mathematicians. Mathematicians, it's mean Jarnik and Warden and Artin and Eminet to the development of modern algebra. The last published book was a collective monograph, which was edited by me and by my husband. The name is Mathematical Word Between Words. The book was published in the edition or in the series History of Mathematics, and the book is written in Czech by the member of our team. The monograph is based on a long-term and intensive study of history of mathematics and also mathematical community. I can say that we tried in a broader culture and historical context discuss the effect of world warfare on the professional life of some outstanding mathematicians, as for example Kolmogorov and Dehn, as well as some European communities. We wrote about the Prague German mathematical community and its professional association, Mathematische Grenzen. We also wrote about Lusitania, it's mean about the Russian mathematical community, and we tried to show its position in the Russian interwar mathematical community. We also wrote about Czech, or if you want, Czechoslovak mathematical community and its relation to the congresses of naturalists and physicians, and also its work on the popularization of mathematics. We also focus on the nature and impact of selected mathematical ideas on the development of certain areas of mathematics and mathematical physics. We wrote about matrix theory and its use in the quantum mechanics. Next, about matroid theory and its relation to the other mathematical discipline. And finally, we also wrote about the role of sweeping in the potential theory. It's mean it's the history of analysis. And also, we tried to describe the axiomatic probability theory and especially the Czech contribution to its development. At the end, in the book, there is also the history of the solution of Hilbert's third problem and historical reminiscences of his solution with the emphasis of the Poland contributions. The impact of a war event and social changes on the development of mathematics teaching is also discussed. We especially tried to show the problem of education of talents and popularization of mathematics. So the colleague described the reform of mathematics teaching in the interwar and postwar Soviet Union. And one article or one chapter described the history, almost a century old history of the popular Czechoslovak magazine Rozhledy matematicko-fyzikální, which were founded in the 1929. Next, our results can be described as two chapters in the two international monographs. First chapter was written by me and my husband. It was in a Czech language, and this chapter described the development of mathematics from the end of the World War I to the end of the World War II. The chapter was published in the big encyclopedia, Science in the Czech Lands, History of Physics, Geography, Geology, Chemistry and Mathematics. The second chapter is written by me, and it's described the women and mathematics at the both universities in Prague, and it was published in the book Against All Odds, also Women's Way to the Mathematical Research Science since 1800. You can see, I think, very nice covers of these two books. Next, our results are three articles published in the Impact journals. You can see the name. The articles were written in English, of course. Two articles were published in the Mathematical Intelligence and in the American Mathematical Monthly. The first article described the life of Saverud Struik. It's mean it is it was she was she was married with famous mathematician Struik, but for us Sally was a typical example of the first women who obtained the doctorate in mathematics at the German University in Prague. The second article described the version of Hall's marriage theorem, but in matrix words or in matrix form. The last very long article was written by Professor Netuka, and this article described the criticism of Carl Neumann's method in the potential theory. Next, our results are case studies on the history of mathematics. Two articles were written in Czech in the journal Pokroky matematiky, fyziky and astronomie. First article described the history of the compact operator, and the second article described the history of Hall theorems. Next, we also wrote about, for the Czech readers, about the history of the Fields Medal and about the activities of International Commission for Education of Mathematics. Then I must say some words about the very, very important results obtained by Polish part of our team. The Polish part describe Polish mathematical community. The team published three articles. First was written by Professor Domoracki and Margareta Stawiska. The article described the history of Polish mathematicians and mathematics in Galicia in between from the World War First until the World War Second. The second article was published by Professor Duda in Antiquitates Mathematice, and this article described 100 years of the Polish Mathematical Society. Third Polish article was published in the Studia Historiae Societarum in the and it was published by Professor Stanislav Domoracki and Margareta Stawiska. This article described Polish mathematicians and mathematics in the Russian Empire from the World War First until the World War Second. As I say, we have also a member from Slovakia It was Professor Bauin. He is from Slovakia, but on the nationality, he is Hungarian. And he was able to help us to describe the situation in the Hungarian mathematical community. In Slovakia, he wrote four articles about four important Hungarian mathematicians as Fejér, Kartézy, László, and Erdős, and for famous Polish journal Antiquitates Mathematice, he wrote article about the Hungarian mathematics development stimuli, it's mean article about the roots of a great Hungarian mathematical school. Next, we also wrote about the German mathematical community, about Felix Hausdorff, Gerhard Hermann Waldemar Kowalewski, and Otto Varga, and also Otto Eduard Neugebauer. I wrote also one article based on deep archival studies, which describe the very sad life history of František Velísek, who died in the first year of the First World War, in not far from Lvov. The main result of our project will be the book with name The Development of Mathematics Between the World Wars. The book is in process. It will be published by World Scientific London, Singapore. The book now has more than 100 pages, and it will be published in April of this year. The book traces the transformation of scientific life within mathematical communities during the interwar period in the Central and Eastern Europe, especially in Germany, Russia, Poland, and Hungary. You can see the name of the chapter. The chapter is about the German mathematics, about the Russian mathematics. There we have four chapters about Polish mathematics and mathematicians in at Jagiellonian University, in Warsaw, and also in Lvov. Next, one chapter is about the mathematical community in Hungary and in Czechoslovakia. And then we have four special chapters which describe the situation in mathematics at the end of the 19th century and in the first third of the 20th century. And then three case studies on set theory in Poland, on potential theory in Europe, and on combinatorics in Europe. We also try to present our results at the conferences, at international conferences in Austria, Czech Republic, Greece, Hungary, Poland, and Slovakia. We also presented our results at the many national seminars, workshop, also lecture for students, teacher, and people who like mathematics. You can see the most important conferences in Czechoslovakia, Austria, Poland, once more Poland, and Greece, Ukraine, once more Poland, Czechoslovakia, and also Poland at the last conference on mathematics and computer sciences. We decided also to make some popularization on our results And I am very proud that the big part of the popularization was made by Polish part of team who presented three very nice exhibition. First exhibition was in Senat of the Republic of Poland. Second exhibition was at the Jubilee Congress of the Poland Mathematical Society, and the last exhibition was at the International Conference Dickstein Forum in Krakow in 2019. I must say that all three exhibitions were prepared by Professor Stanislav Domoracki. We also published some article in the newspapers and popularizing journals, and we prepared cycle lectures for seniors, which is at our university, and we also presented our books at the books presentation and exhibition in Prague and also in Germany. What I can say as the conclusion, I think that our project put together very good collaborators from Czech Republic, Poland, Slovakia, Ukraine, and USA. Our team members collaborated with mathematicians, historians, historians of mathematics and science from Austria, Italy, Czech Republic, France, Germany, Greece, Hungary, Poland, Russia, Slovakia, Ukraine, and USA. Our project created, I think, good platforms for future international research and collaboration and cooperation, not only between the collaborators. I think that our project obtained many new results, but also many new questions and open new problems. The team hopes and believes that we'll be able to continue in his activities and obtain new results in the future. So I was and I am very proud that our project was international and that we have such a good group of collaborators from Poland. So thank you very much for your attention, and I must apologize for my terrible English and pronunciation, but I hope that you understand me thanks to the text which was written in the presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.
Proszę Państwa, bardzo bym nie chciał przedłużać, ale chciałbym w tym dodatku do tego wystąpienia chciałbym powiedzieć, dlaczego zgodziłem się na współpracę w ramach tego grantu, do którego potem zaprosiłem panią dr Stawiską i profesora Zalicznego, i chciałbym wspomnieć o roli, jaką w realizacji tego grantu odegrała też nasza Komisja Historii Nauki Polskiej Akademii Umiejętności. Po to, że pan profesor Duda był naturalnym kandydatem na członka tego zespołu, pani profesor Wetwarzowa prowadziła z nim rozmowy i zachęty. Chciałbym też powiedzieć o klimacie, że w tych no, prawie 200 stronach, które liczą nasze trzy artykuły, chcieliśmy w klimacie prac projektu przedstawić matematykę w Polsce w okresie międzywojennym, jej sukcesy, trudności, wpływ na inne nauki. Dobrze, więc w czwartym rozdziale tej książki, którą pani profesor Beczwarzowa no, przedstawiała i wymieniała też tytuły tych rozdziałów opozycji Uniwersytetu Jagiellońskiego i środowiska matematycznego przed i po pierwszej wojnie światowej, o formułowaniu aktywności Lwowskiej Szkoły Matematycznej, ale gdzieś mi zginęło. O, przepraszam. O transformacji warszawskiego ośrodka matematycznego i następstwie po I wojnie światowej, teraz już dobrze. Więc rzeczywiście jest tego prawie że 200 stron. Pan profesor Duda napisał o korzeniach współczesnej matematyki w Polsce i o tym, że teoria mnogości to była tym wehikułem współczesnej matematyki w Polsce. Skąd to się wzięło? Musielibyśmy się, proszę Państwa, wrócić i dlatego chciałem o tym powiedzieć. Jeszcze nie było mowy o żadnym grancie, ale w 2013 roku miała miejsce konferencja o recepcji nauk matematyczno-przyrodniczych w Europie Środkowo-Wschodniej, którą wtedy wspólnie organizowaliśmy z Komisją Historii Nauki, Instytutem Historii Nauki i Techniki, Instytutem Matematyki, Uniwersytetu Pedagogicznego, Uniwersytetu Rzeszowskiego, potem już nie będę powtarzał tych współorganizatorów z oddziałem krakowskim Polskiego Towarzystwa Matematycznego, czy pierwsza konferencja była też realizowana przy współpracy z Wydziałem Matematyki i Informatyki UJ. No i oczywiście Wydziałem Fizyki, Matematyki i Informatyki Politechniki Krakowskiej. Następna konferencja w 2015 organizowała ją Komisja Historii Nauki. Już od tego czasu odbywała się w gmachu Polskiej Akademii Umiejętności. Nie wymieniam wszystkich współorganizatorów, ale głównym organizatorem była Komisja Historii Nauki. Po pewnym czasie dołączyła do nas Akademia Historii Nauki i Wydział Mechaniki i Matematyki Uniwersytetu imienia Franki we Lwowie. Wcześniej wspólnie z koleżanką Stawiską mieliśmy taki odczyt w Pizie o matematykach w czasie I wojny światowej na ziemiach polskich. Potem w Stanach Zjednoczonych była organizowana specjalna sesja w San Antonio i o doktorantach i wybitnych absolwentach UJ koleżanka Stawiska przedstawiła nasz referat, ale w sumie to przyjemnie, że taka sesja w Stanach Zjednoczonych w Teksasie się odbyła, matematyka w Polsce. W 2017 kolejna konferencja, to nie było jeszcze to Dickstein Forum, rozwój matematyki, nauk pokrewnych w Europie Środkowo-Wschodniej i po dłuższym namyśle Rady Naukowej Konferencji postanowiliśmy podtrzymać ten cykl spotkań co dwa lata i nadać mu wspólną nazwę. Zresztą tutaj wziąłem z artykułu Ryty Majkowskiej, która zauważyła, że pomysły stworzenia organizacyjnych ram naukowych w Akademii Umiejętności do badań w zakresie historii nauki pochodzą od Dicksteina i Birkenmayera, Ludwika. Michał Kokowski dodał w dyskusji po referacie, że usiłowania matematyka Dicksteina i fizyków Nathansona i Birkenmayera były pionierskie nawet w skali światowej. Dodajmy jeszcze, że Dickstein był prezesem Polskiego Towarzystwa Matematycznego i to jeszcze w latach, kiedy siedziba towarzystwa była w Krakowie, to miało to miejsce do 1936 roku. Więc zorganizowaliśmy te Dickstein Forum i tu już znaleźliśmy współprzymierzeńców, Politechnikę w Pradze. Z tych niewymienionych. No i Radą Naukową tego pierwszego Dickstein Forum i drugiego tworzył no, Radę Naukową tworzyli. Przewodniczącym był profesor Duda, profesor Demidow, który jest prezydentem Międzynarodowej Akademii Historii i Nauk, profesor Kokoski, profesor Taras Banach ze Lwowa, Martyna Beczwarzowa, pani prezes ówczesna oddziału Krakowskiego Polskiego Towarzystwa Matematycznego, profesor Murawski, profesor Woleński, profesor Andrzej Kajetan Wróblewski i profesor Michał Zariczny. Tak. Co nam się udało? W 2013 roku wydać specjalny tom Technical Transaction. To w większości były to materiały z pierwszej konferencji. W języku angielskim to wydaliśmy. Oczywiście nie ma teraz czasu, żeby nawet i spis treści, ale odsyłam Państwa do wydawnictwa i za rok to było z pierwszej konferencji, a z drugiej konferencji, a nie wiem, coś mi się tu pokręciło, też udało nam się wydać jeszcze te materiały, tak, dwa razy to samo. I z drugiej konferencji wydaliśmy w 2015 roku. Tu jest spis treści po polsku. Też wydaliśmy ten tom czasopisma po angielsku. No i potem była konferencja w 2017 roku i tu już artykuły bądź były kierowane na zaproszenie pana profesora Kokoskiego do czasopisma Akademii Umiejętności. Niektóre artykuły matematyczne zostały wydane przez serię szóstą roczników Polskiego Towarzystwa Matematycznego Antiquitates Mathematice. Tu pokazuję, no akurat to jeszcze było w czasie, kiedy mogliśmy kontaktowo się widzieć, program konferencji, program Dickstein Forum. No, mieliśmy gości z Litwy, z Rosji, z Węgier, ze Słowacji, z Czech. Rzeczywiście z Ukrainy sporo osób uczestniczyło w tych konferencjach. Z Aten. Także proszę Państwa, co jeszcze chcę powiedzieć? To między innymi ten cykl konferencji, który został zapoczątkowany znacznie wcześniej niż propozycja uczestnictwa w grancie. To był jeden z powodów, dla którego się zgodziłem. Uczestnictwo w konferencjach, o których pani profesor Beczwarzowa wspominała, one prawie że rokrocznie tam z dokładnością do Epsilona się odbywają. Od czasu do czasu udawało mi się krótkie sprawozdania o tych konferencjach zamieszczać w Antiquitates, to jest w tym zamku w Podebradach, gdzie te konferencje się odbywają. Tu mamy konferencje o tyle są ciekawe, że one są wielojęzyczne. Słowacki, czeski, angielski i czasem jeszcze inne języki dominują. Z jednej strony to jest o tyle dobre, że to w jakiś sposób pozwala się obsłuchać z językiem i czasem łatwiej coś w archiwum znaleźć i popracować. Także to jest nie tłumaczenie wszystkiego na angielski ma czasem też bardzo dobre skutki dla uczestników. Tak, to jest pomnik Jerzego z Podebrad na rynku, w samym centrum. Oprócz jeszcze tych konferencji jak Podebrady, tu już nie będę mówił o tych. Na ostatniej konferencji w Podebradach, która nie wiem, zupełnie jakimś cudem, że pomiędzy tymi wszystkimi zamknięciami i lockdownami się odbyła, to prawda. Chciałem wspomnieć o moim odczycie, bo wydaje mi się, że jeszcze jest wiele do odkrycia w historii matematyki okresu międzywojennego. No chociażby tu tylko tyle chcę wspomnieć, bo to nie miejsce. Mówiłem o działalności dydaktycznej członków Lwowskiej Szkoły Matematycznej w okresie międzywojennym, bo czasem się mówi, że Banach nie dbał o studentów, że wykładał tak czy inaczej. Po prostu coś nieprawdopodobnego, jak ten człowiek był pracowity. Wykładał różne przedmioty już od 23 roku, podstawy geometrii różniczkowej, teoria funkcji wielu zmiennych. Współprowadził seminaria z Rudziewiczem, Żylińskim. Sam prowadził seminarium z teorii funkcji wielu zmiennych. No, to tylko absolutnie fragment tego, o czym mówiłem. To jest też dość, no my czasem lubimy, że tak powiem, powtarzać to, co się ukazało w niektórych książkach popularnonaukowych, bo to jest nam łatwiej, to jest nam łatwiej to wszystko przyjąć, niemniej jednak oprócz, chcę powiedzieć, że Banach był wspaniałym dydaktykiem, wspaniale się do tego przygotowywał i po prostu rzeczywiście nie można go kojarzyć z jakimś tam siedzeniem tylko, bo to była też ciężka praca w kawiarni szkockiej, ale rzeczywiście mało spał, dużo pracował i ja nie wiem, czy ktokolwiek dzisiaj by się odważył tak prowadzić rokrocznie coraz to nowe, różne przedmioty. Oczywiście o tych publikacjach pani profesor Meczwarzowa już wspomniała. O, tu jeszcze mam fragment, że i geometrię analityczną, i teorię mnogości, i rachunek nieskończonościowy, teorię mnogości punktowej. Dobra, to już zostawmy. Chcę tylko powiedzieć, że między innymi na ile można było w tym artykule o Lwowie, też chcieliśmy o tym wspomnieć, ponieważ to miało wpływ w ogóle na rozwój matematyki, na rozwój i też i innych nauk, o tym też się powiedzieli. Te wyniki pracy rzeczywiście prezentowaliśmy też na za granicą, w szczególności w takim bardzo, że tak powiem, sympatycznym, trwającym od lat seminarium z historii matematyki, które jest w Miesenbachu, ale też i na seminarium zespołu historii matematyki, który działa przy IHN-ie i Centrum Kopernika, to prowadzi pan profesor Więcław. Potem tak, to u niegośmy prowadzili. No, udało mi się też w setną rocznicę śmierci kuzyny być na konferencji na Ukrainie i rzeczywiście te jego dokonania kuzyny, którego właściwie możemy nazwać tym, który stworzył podwaliny dla przyszłych sukcesów, dla ośrodka matematycznego we Lwowie, któremu z ośrodka we Lwowie udało się stworzyć ośrodek matematyki współczesnej na początku XX wieku, jest bardzo szanowany też na Ukrainie. Wśród jego doktorantów było też wielu Ukraińców. No i oczywiście o ostatnimi czasy mówiliśmy chyba ze dwa razy na posiedzeniach Komisji Historii i Nauki o matematyce we Lwowie w czasie II wojny światowej i o różnych obliczach matematyki we Lwowie w okresie międzywojennym. Między innymi mieliśmy taki referat w Grecji. Dziękuję bardzo. Myślę, że w telegraficznym skrócie, tak jakbym się chciał wyjaśnić, dlaczego podjęliśmy się współpracy w ramach tego grantu, który pani profesor Beczwarzowa zaproponowała. Dziękuję serdecznie.